Today I'm going to make a lower third that can spread horizontally. First of all, under project, right click, new, and then hit sequence. I usually set the frame rate 30 because I usually shoot video in 30 FPS. That's why I need the effect to be 30 FPS as well. Okay, go here, add title and solid bar. Simply add a solid bar to create a background color so that it can be easier to edit. The color doesn't matter because you can always change the background color here. Let's add one more solid color on top. I don't want the top to be red, so I pick blue to be the screen color. Then add video effect, distort, and then crop to select the area to be cropped. Just tweak the attributes, and usually I want it to be a bit centered, so I set the left to be 35 and top to be 80. It's just for 1080p. If you have different resolution, you don't need to follow this setting. That's just my personal preference. Now we've just added the crop effect, we can create a static video effect before we animate it. Add a video effect and apply a directional blur. Let's see. Increase the length, let's take a look at the screen, and you'll see a horizontally fading blue bar. See it, right? Let's switch it back to 0 and make it flow horizontally again. Let's see how long it can be. It's close to around 290 and 300. No wonder. Okay. Now let's tweak the rotation angle and you'll see the stretched bar comes at an angle. Comes back and forth. Change the angle again. Change it this way. Rolled up and down. Nice. Let's do it this way. Move it around. Of course, you don't want it to be like that. Simply set the angle back to 0. Let me set the length to be something like that. Okay. 270. I don't want a red background, so simply change the color back to dark and see what I get. I see. Okay. That seems okay. Then just remove the background. Alright, this is the screen we want. How can I make it spread like this? Our target image will be at a second keyframe, but not the first one. That's why jump to the second keyframe and hit the dots to enable keyframes. Also add keyframes to length, so you'll see the ending result at the second keyframe. Now let's get back to the first keyframe, the leftmost position of your effect clip, and add keyframes. Set the feather of the first keyframe to 90 and it looks disappearing. Now I set feather back to 0 and change directional blur to 0 at the first keyframe. Then the box looks like this. I want the box to be spreading left and right at the second keyframe. Then what I want to do is go back to the first keyframe and turn up the left attribute. Try 50 for the right, make it 50 also. Then it looks disappeared at the first keyframe. When I play the clip, it's slowly spreading to the left and right until it gets to the second keyframe. This is a screen I wanna see. Now I want to hold the second keyframe until I reach the third keyframe. Then I add dots at the third keyframe. So now, When I left arrow to the second keyframe and play, I won't see any changes on the screen. You'll see the numbers don't jump on the left. Skip to the third keyframe, and if I want the blue box to collapse gradually, simply hit down arrow to the last keyframe. Here I don't need to use all the previous keyframes, because I only need to bump up the fade attribute to make the box disappear. Hit feather, make it 90 at the first keyframe, go back to the third keyframe and see what we get. It now slowly fading out until it collapses completely. This is the most basic lower third. Let's play it again. Oops, coming out. Fading out. Now we are done with the effects. Control S. I forgot to save. It's optional, but I usually save just to ensure proper backup. Now just pretend we are done. Then hit Control M. And bring up the export menu. I usually pick H265 for codec, 17 for quality. Then hit export to a video file called test effect. The name is totally up to you. Hit save to proceed. The process should be fairly short. The better machine you have, the quicker you render the video. Alright, it's done. Just pretend that reopen Olive Editor. Simply go inside the folder and double click Olive Editor. Actually, you can use the effect video on other editors as it's in MP4 format. Hit OK, Control I, and select your own video. Drag it to the timeline and go to wherever white space and right click sequence setting. And you should see that the frame rate is 30 FPS. That means this video is shooting at 30 frames per second, 1920x1080. This setting has to be matched with your effect video. Control I again and select the effect video that we created previously. The effect video is now under the project panel. Drag it down below. The effect video also has audio underneath, but we don't need it, right? Then we can left click the effect video and then right click to unlink the video and audio. Now you can remove the audio part and keep only the video. Oh, wait a minute, the effect is hiding the original video underneath. What we can do is go back to the effect video, left click, and go to add video effect. Keying and then chroma key. Then hit key color. Pick screen color and key out the background color. You can either click the actual image or click the color palette until you are happy with the result. Oops, now you'll see the effect being shown on the original video. Let's play it. Hit L to play. Too fast. Let's play it again. Just move it this way. Wait it again. Pay attention to the screen. Okay, so we can now add some text on top of the effect blue box. Simply add title here. Let me change the text color. I'll just do it quick here, you can fine-tune it later on. Let's build it. See the sample text? Of course, you can further tweak it. We are pretty much done with the effect. That's it. Hope it helps. Ciao.